In today's society, modern progress paves its way through American history, taking down so many places of happiness, love, and even sometimes sorrow. When we lose these places, our past is stripped away forever, unless it's put into a book, film, or pictures. Sometimes when you find such a beautiful location, you may be surprised of the history that is linked to such beauty. All of us are wandering souls looking for answers to the living or the past, and yet still we leave an imprint of our legacies on this earth.
When we're looking at the history of the church, one of the things that students always notice, and one of the most common questions, is where do Catholics fit into the history of America? Obviously, the story from 1600 on, down until the American Revolution itself, doesn't feature a great deal of the Catholic story. But when we look at the church today in America, there are all kinds of Catholics in every state, and they make up a wide variety of ethnicities, languages.
Protesters demonstrated outside the Vatican today as a disgraced U.S. cardinal said Mass for Pope John Paul II. Cardinal Bernard Law resigned following the sexual abuse scandal.
I think we're dealing with an entirely different situation. The Catholic Church, which was the target of our investigation, is one of the most secretive organizations in the world. And penetrating that organization,
the culture of the Catholic Church in America, is somewhat different. If you were to go to South America, to some of the countries that are heavily Catholic, if you were to go to Spain, or to Italy, or to other areas where the Catholic presence is very pronounced, most would find that there are some differences in the
American. Today, police dragged two leaders of the protest from St. Peter's Square as they were trying to give out leaflets. The Conference of Cardinals is refusing to comment to the press about anything.
Something linked to a suicide, or whether it's just a sexual offending of people that haven't committed suicide, they need to tell us about it, and the onus is really on them to tell us about when they find that offending. But what often happens is, the victims come to us, not the church.
Even now, the church doesn't come to you?
No.
Searching for the unknown takes endurance and faith within yourself to answer the calls from forgotten history, from standing places with no life within the walls, but they still have stories to be told. Armed with only a camera and joining like-minded researchers, hearing their passions and their stories of the abandoned, forgotten history, it's an endurance to help tell these stories of the forgotten past, and not a journey to prove who is the best, but to show the best of the journey.
The Catholic Church always embodies the culture that it's part of. It is different, and it has a unique Catholic culture unto itself. But just because someone is Catholic doesn't mean that they cease to be American. And so some of the American instincts, some of the felt needs of those raised in American culture are always going to be met and addressed by the Catholic Church. And sometimes the grammar or the discussions that are a part of the Catholic Church in one country might be somewhat different than the cultures or the expressions in another country.
place is absolutely amazing. It's beautiful. The structure is absolutely gorgeous. And I can't believe they're going to tear this down. That's what we're here for.
I do. Because it's not making nobody money no more.
That's a sad fact. It's all about money and progress. So, stay tuned.
We got to the top of them stairs.
Uh-huh.
It sounded like something was like,
to be the doors closing, squeaky.
The same thing.
Might have been the hydraulic hinge. All right, here we go. We are actually inside. This place is actually going to be torn down. We actually just talked to somebody who was walking around here that was, when she was a kid, she said that she remembers when they built it. And they said that it's going to be another year before it's actually down. It's horrible. I can't believe it, dude.
Beautiful structure, beautiful property.
It is. Absolutely is. You hearing something, Jed? No? Frogs?
Frogs.
And as you can see, this floor is gutted. And the floor above us is gutted as well.
That's interesting.
On this side of the building. What I don't like about this is that such a beautiful structure. Fireworks. Literally nothing wrong with the building.
Yeah.
Literally nothing wrong with the building. And they want to tear it down. Again, removing our history so our future can't even remember anything about it or even see it and experience it. It's unbelievable. I mean, in here. This is weird. Bishop's apartment.
Is it really?
Yeah.
He doesn't live here. Obviously not.
No. That was a Bishop's apartment.
Wow. That's what? Where Rick Hayes saw that dude.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Peering out the window.
Yeah.
The third floor.
Yeah.
Earlier in the week, we asked a very good friend of ours, Rick Hayes, to join us at this special location. Rick is very well known for his abilities to connect to the unknown. Rated as one of the top 25 psychics in the United States, he brings such warmth and respect for those left behind through his connections.
Getting ready to go inside and Hold on. There's a gentleman in spirit coming forward to the top window, the third window, and he's bringing up his hands like this, and he is, I don't know if he's trying to give me the cross symbol. No, wait a minute. He's doing something on the window. He's smudging, putting smudges on the window. I don't know what he's... Let me go up and see. He's put something on the window. Okay, I got it. I already got it. It's 2 Peter 3:4. So let's look that up real quick. It may be a message for us. We just got here, so we haven't even got inside yet. I just pulled it up, 2 Peter 3:4, and this is the message we received before we even got into the place. We're doing an investigation here. Where is this coming? He promised. Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. I want to read that last line. Ever since our ancestors died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. Thank you for the message. And basically what I feel what he's sharing is this place is empty. This place is starting to fall apart. It's starting to crumble, but he says life goes on. So I'm anxious to get in there and see what we get. So I'm with a great team, and we'll go in there and see if we can get more for you.
Well, what I didn't tell you, that there is 50 priests buried on his property.
There is?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, their bodies is, but they must be pretty active, because it didn't take us to even going down this small road, and I looked up and he was already approaching us. So just had a white butterfly go right in front of me. Did you see that?
I seen that, dude. Did you see that, Pat?
Yeah.
It's so awesome. So, well, let's go in and see if we can get more.
All right.
To actually witness Rick connecting with the unknown is truly a spiritual experience that can be so rewarding. It would take us at least 10 more minutes to actually go inside because Rick was just feeling so much energy from this location.
And of course, as I always do with investigations, I don't know anything about the place. I don't ask any research and ask anything about the research or anything like that when I come in. So this is the first time I've been at this location as well. So it's very important for me personally to work with great investigation teams, but also for me to be basically not knowledgeable of the location or anything about the location, because I feel like they're tour guides, and they're guiding me and sharing with me what their experiences and memory was here. So that's what we're doing now. He's asked me to go down to, I'm being told to go down to the chapel.
Got the cold chills right now.
I just started getting cold chills.
They could have.
God, I feel like it just went right through me.
I'm going to switch my glasses out so I can see a little better. I got my outside glasses on, but I know what they're asking me to do. The camera will probably stay at the same place, but they're asking me to, I'll get up to where I need to be, but I'm being called to go up and to be anointed, to do the bread and the drinking of the wine. Absolutely incredible. So, and there's a feeling here of not just one presence, but there's several presences here. I'm being told to keep it holy. So, and again, the location we're in is a location of religious stature. So that is why I'm getting these kind of messages. If I go to a location of, for example, of a hospital, I'm going to get medical messages. If I go to an abandoned prison, I'm going to get messages of experiences there based on that prison. This is what's happening right now. We are in a religious location, so I am getting the religious messages. They're asking me to come up, so I'm going to walk up
you know, going up to, I'll just walk.
You want me to stay here? Is that what you said?
Can you get me?
Yeah.
Okay. Still rolling?
Yeah,
I am. Yep.
Okay. One other, this is just my thoughts, but when you're doing investigations, and especially doing investigations with me, again, I have a lot of respect for the locations we go to, because it's a structure, not just a building of brick and mortar, but it is also a place of memories and experiences. And one of the things I really try to do, and I think it's very important, it's not to move things around, leave things as it be. We've got strips of wood here on the floor. Instead of moving them, I just instead walk over them, because I'm not here to move and redecorate, so I'm here to learn. So that's another one of my thoughts I feel when you go to these locations. If you look over to the windows here, I mean, this is just an amazing place, the arches, and you can't, they got them boarded up, but the stained glass, they're actually showing me the beautiful stained glass and how the sun would come in and it almost like draped the pews and the places where I just looked over here on this side. They're showing me the pews, and actually there's others that are actually kneeling down there right now. They're showing me how they knelt as they prayed. Incredible.
Second floor over here.
And I want to just say this, not on camera or anything, but
not on camera.
I just
well, I'm gonna do this. All right, let's do this real quick.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
All right, check this out. While Rick was talking, we actually turned the camera off because there's something personal Rick wanted to share with us, and he did not want this on film or whatnot. Besides sweating our asses off, we heard, Pat, Rick, and myself, heard in this direction, doors slamming and shutting. Now, as you can see, this part's gutted out. There's a door to the stairs. We didn't see anybody come through there. Around the corner is a door to a breezeway. It goes to the gymnasium. Now we're actually going to head over there and see if that's the same sound we heard. But it was two doors. Don't know. We actually ran outside. I ran in the gymnasium, ran upstairs. There was no one in the gym. I can't tell you. I can't tell you. I don't know, dude.
And it's daylight.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be dark.
All right, this is the door, dude, to the gym. Is that what we heard?
I don't know. I don't feel like it. That's the same sound.
It was a lot louder, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, to me, Rick, I don't know about you, but didn't it sound like it was like a heavy metal door?
Yeah.
Like, you know, with the latches?
Mm-hmm. So that's the first thing I thought of because of the stairwell. Remember I said that the doors were so close together, closed?
Yeah, oh yeah, like the one we just passed by the stairs.
Yeah.
That would, let's go mess with that door.
That's not it.
Let's go after that door of the stairwell.
That's more like it.
But no squeakiness. There was a squeakiness to it.
No, it made a noise when it shut too.
Yeah.
Didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it did. Dude, I don't know. And an audio.
And I don't know why, but also I just got the, maybe this is where he's from. He said Corpus Christi, Texas.
Really?
Whoa, yeah. Get the f*** out of here.
That's what I just heard when we was walking out the door.
Oh, wait until I show you this picture.
Oh my God, dude.
That's insane.
After hearing what Rick just told us in the stairwell about Corpus Christi, we made our way outside so Pat could show Rick why it was such a shock to us hearing him speak about the city in Texas.
All right, I'm recording right now, Pat. Why don't you explain?
All right. Did I just hear somebody talking?
I thought I did.
They don't want us to leave.
Yeah.
It was very loud. But Rick was just telling us as we were walking back up the stairwell that he felt a connection to Corpus Christi.
Corpus Christi, Texas. I couldn't pronounce it correctly, but that's what I got, yeah.
Well, we were going through the gymnasium, using the bathroom. Corpus Christi gets a big Christmas gift, so it's about a monastery.
I'm speechless, and that very seldom happens. That's wild.
That's why I said
suspect Corpus Christi gets a big Christmas gift. And they renovated.
See,
sometimes I get things and it's like, I don't know what they mean, I don't know what they're explaining to me, but I just say what they tell me. And then when I get validations like this, as soon as it says, it's like, wow. Yeah. So
that's
insane. A great validation.
That blew me away. That blew me away, dude.
That's amazing.
To actually see Rick surprised with the validation of Corpus Christi was amazing. That's what all of us in this field want, is to find validation. And when we do, it's one of the most exciting moments we can feel. And it definitely was for Rick.
That was down around the corner. In the other part. Something came from there.
Oh, this place again.
Yeah.
We've not been in there yet.
Pat and I have.
Is that firework? Is that firework?
That was inside.
Yeah.
Yeah, that wasn't a firework. Is that a firework?
That one was.
It's fireworks.
That loud one?
No, that was inside.
Creep factor just officially set in. Dude, you're feeding back.
I know.
Oh, What? I'm sorry, dude. It was me. I've seen where the door went. What? Shut the fuck up, dude. Did you hear me? What? Goddamn spider right next to me. You tell me not to move?
Where?
It's a little one.
Here you are.
Oh, God. I gotta fart again.
What fart? It's me moving the recorder around. That was his butt. That was actually legit his butt that time.
I'm getting creeped out now. Thanks.
Yeah, me too.
Thanks a lot, dude. What is that, a grab and go? Drive-by grabbing? Hello? Go. Go. Okay, here we go. It's locked. Scared to grab it.
What?
So don't be scared to grab it.
I'm not.
What are you doing?
What?
What? You got it?
There's something there.
Oh shit. Take, unplug it. Let's hear it. Unplug it. Go ahead.
You're not hearing it without the earphones.
I just heard something. Right there.
What?
Was that you?
I didn't hear that.
First session. All right, to any peaceful spirits.
Right there when you said that, I heard it.
What?
And you can hear it as plain as day on this.
With us in the basement, and no sounds leaking into the building except an occasional echo from the fireworks nearby, we are really left with no explanation of what we captured.
Peaceful spirits.
Right there.
What? Peaceful spirits.
Right there. Right there.
What?
I'm hot.
I'm not.
I am, dude. I'm fucking burning up. I don't know why. Come on. Are you kidding me, dude?
Stairs.
Why is a place like this got stuff happening? Why? Is there spirits here trying to preserve this place so it doesn't get torn down? I'm trying to make it known? I mean, we're the only ones that's ever been here. And maybe they're surprised that we're actually here trying to talk to them.
What was that?
There's the Whistler fireworks.
Oh, okay.
Anybody wants to know, that's me breathing heavy because I'm burning up.
Fireworks?
Fireworks, yep. It's got to be someone close by. Excuse me.
Whoa.
Dude, I just heard a door. A knock.
Is that what that was?
Right behind me. Fucking A. Shit you not.
I heard something, but I'm getting to the point where I'm starting to ignore things.
That was right in here.
It's on here. I heard it. I thought it took something.
No. Hello? Audio session number, God knows what it is. Did you just knock on something in here?
That's fireworks, right?
That's fireworks.
It's driving me nuts.
So we come here out of respect. We understand what this building was used for. It's a holy place.
Yeah. How do you feel about them going to tear it down?
Don't.
Oh, I heard that.
Dude, that sounded like a fucking door or something.
Did someone come in? Did someone come in, dude?
I don't know.
Do I hear fireworks right now?
Yep, and a fart. Yes. Oh. Hello? Yep.
Let's go.
Let's go. What the f, dude? I heard that shit. Like the last time, remember? When me and Pat was here with Rick. All that noise in the background is fireworks, by the way. And in audio. What, Pat?
You see? When the light just came on out there, I can't feel it, so there you are. Parking lights. Big lights.
Hello? If someone's in here, we have permission. You better not be sneaking in here to vandalize this place.
Is it all fireworks?
Yeah.
Man, it's in this area, it sounds horrible. Because there ain't nothing in here.
I know. Father? Bishop? My stomach? If you got anything you'd like to say to us, please, please talk to us, because we don't know when we'll have another chance to let you do this. They're going to tear the building down. And all the history, but this place will be gone.
It's me.
This is fireworks?
Yeah. Man, dude. Oh. Chad, hold that. Oh.
You guys are not hot.
Now I am a little bit.
I'm a little warm.
My head is on fire, if you want to know the truth. My head is on fire. My body's not, but my head feels like an inferno right now.
It's fucking hot, man. I'm sweating.
Go back in there. Back there. I don't know why, but it just felt like what you guys were saying. It felt like somebody was watching us back there.
It does, dude. It feels like someone's...
I feel okay here. When I was in there, it was worse back in there.
We hate to see you go.
Come back and visit you one more time, maybe?
Yeah, we'll come back and visit. All right, our Urban X for today is about to wrap up.
Been out here all day, man.
Yeah, we've been out here all day. So, we're out of here. Got some few things going on. We're out. Good night. Urban X. TSEU. We're out.
Done for today.
Have a good night. All right. It's getting late. I've been inside. We've all been inside for a while. On this Urban X edition of the search. All of a sudden, I just got this overwhelming drain, no energy. And you can see part of the building behind me. This is just one side. There's so many things that is sad about this place, but then again, the structure is absolutely beautiful. And it's gonna be taken away because of the sins that was committed within this religion. This place was sold for that, to help pay for that. So I'm going to sign off. It's the end of this night. And this place is going to be gone very soon. I'm out.
After we spent a long day at this beautiful historical location, I would return once more for the ultimate isolation phase, spending 3 hours inside, testing my nerves, and maybe, just maybe, connecting with the unknown.
Place, it's crazy. About an hour and a half in, that was my water bottle. It's kind of creepy here. There's some weird stuff going on, so I'm gonna walk around and see what's going on. So I'm gonna get to a certain spot and I'll jump back on. This was the dining room. There's a lot of stuff in here. So, I guess it was emptied out and they brought more shit in here. I'm gonna go back to the kitchen because that's where shit kind of tripped out. I'm actually gonna do an audio session in here. Sounds like there's something moving. Audio session number one, Crystal Ray, ultimate isolation phase. I'm gonna do an audio burst real quick. Am I hearing somebody in here that's talking?
Hello? Okay, I'm hearing dripping. That's from the faucet in the sink. Right there. Is there actually someone still here that used to work here or used to preach the word of God here? See, this place is, I mean, look. I mean, the old coolers. Look at that big ass old meter. I mean, if they're gonna, they shouldn't throw this stuff away, at least auction it off or repurpose it for something else. Because, I mean, I'm sure there's other people that could use it besides me. And, I'm gonna go down this way. Heard some kind of noise. Hold on, I think someone's outside. Let me check real quick. So, I went outside, there was nothing. There's all kinds of noises going on here. You know, it's building was established in 1959. I mean, it's been through a lot. I tried to turn these lights off, but who needs lights off all the time? And, so, almost lost my footing. I guess these lights that are on is security lights, and I'm telling you, this place is creepy as but when you're doing a place by yourself, it's a trip. It's definitely a trip. Probably got this too close to my face. So I'm gonna go down here, do an audio session again. Audio burst, number two, if there's actually something here that used to teach the word of God, I'm just here, how do you feel about something about them tearing this building down? I mean, God, I hate this. I mean, is there something you want to talk about? Something you want to express? Can you give any kind of indication that you're here? It sucks. I gotta go to the bathroom right now. What a great time to have to go to the bathroom. All right. If you want to say something real quick. I'm gonna play this back. All right, and in audio.
Audio burst number two. If there's actually something here that used to teach the word of God. I'm just here, how do you feel about something about them tearing this building down? I mean, God, I hate this. I mean, is there something you want to talk about? Something you want to express? Indication that you're here. It sucks how you go to the bathroom right now. What a great time to have to go to the bathroom. indication that you're here?
At this point of the night, my nerves were shot. But what I captured was definitely unexplainable. Before you can hear me breathe, there was a very faint noise that had human characteristics to it. First, I'll play back the voice recorder footage where the voice was captured. Then I'll play back the cam audio where it wasn't captured.
Do you have any kind of indication that you're here?
Can you give any kind of indication that you're here? Can you give any kind of indication that you're here? Okay, I just heard something. There was something on there. I'm going to have to review it better when I put it on the computer, but there was definitely something on there. All right, I'm going to turn this off because I got to piss, and I'm not taking you guys in the bathroom with me. No way. Not happening.
All around me right now, I'm hearing walking, door shutting. Just like that. That was right behind me. Just sucks. I gotta turn this camera around because I can't see. Hello? Anybody here? Oh my god, that was behind me too. After I said that, it's like back and forth. My nerves are shot. I don't know how much longer I can do this anymore. It's like 2 o'clock. I was gonna do a broadcast, my final one, but there's just stuff going on and I don't wanna leave this floor yet. It's crazy. Hold on, I'm gonna sit here for a minute. Can you even see? Okay, now that sound is probably this metal. Oh, that was movement. Hello? Oh, every time I say hello, you make a noise. That sounded like someone talking. I need to see if someone's outside. Nope. There's no one outside. Oh, I'm officially freaked out. Let me turn this down, that's bright. This is tough. I ain't gonna lie. This is really tough. Tougher than I thought it would be. It's not like when I was a kid, teenager, early 20s when I was doing this, all pumped with adrenaline, ready to rock it out. And now I'm 48 years old. It's not like that anymore.
If there's someone here, if you're moving around, can you just stop for a minute and talk with me, please? And that is my squeaky shoes, by the way.
All right, I gotta turn this down. It's light. All right. Please, I mean no disrespect. Oh my God. That's another f***ing door. And walking. Oh, this sucks. Alright, I don't know how much longer I can take this. I don't know if someone's in the building, snuck in or what. Alright, real quick, if you want to say anything, feel free to, because I'm about to wrap this up or call for backup. I might call for backup, because I don't know if someone's outside messing with me. I need to go see if there's cars. This is bright. Let's see if we can set this right here. Okay. Oh my God. This is crazy. Who are you? Really? What are you doing? Fuck, does it, okay, I'm gonna have to cut this. I need to see if someone's in the building. I'm out. 11 to 12, 12 to 1, 1 to 2, 3 hours is pretty good. I wanna go 1 more hour, but I might have to call some backup because it seems like something's going on. All right, I'm cutting this. I need to get a breather. My nerves are shot. All right, I think my isolation phase is about done. I'm out.
As I left, my nerves shot from the isolation phase. I knew that this would be my last time inside this beautiful building. It is such a shame to know that someday, soon, I will return and there will be just an empty field. All the memories physically torn away from the face of the earth. This is just one story among many. So many places today face demolition for modern progress, and our history becomes forgotten history. We need to save our past, either by documentation on film, pictures, or books. Even though some of our past can be embarrassing, and even shameful, we still cannot forget it. We need to learn from it, grow from it, and embrace the wonderful memories that once thrived at some of these places, such as the seminary. But above all, when venturing into these places, we must remain respectful, because all of the abandoned America at one time held active lives of prosperity, love, and everyday routines. And those are the memories we need to hold on to and tell the world before our past is nothing but forgotten history.